So that combined with non-gender is, you know, is an exciting battle.
What I was doing 3 years ago, they do now. But 3 years ago, combining this art is when I started. Today is in fact my anniversary. Today, 3 years ago, I started my business.
Congratulations. So art, design, gender together. Tell us about the ecosystem that is there in Germany, and tell us what are some of the challenges there, and what are you doing to address them at an ecosystem level?
Okay, very complicated question, but my favorite one. So Germany is definitely, from my point of view, very gender sensitive. It has it's connected with all political refugee topics. Because somehow I feel that we have to explain the whole world that we are the leader in everything, which is for me very hypocritical. They say, I'm not like this, try to integrate and involve everybody in every discussion. So finally we don't have one gender or two gender, we have 1,000 genders, and I'm speaking about Berlin, the capital, which is a very contemporary city. So we have non-binary. When you fill in some documents, you can also choose. You don't have to choose between woman and man. You can be neutral. So your biological gender is different than your sexual orientation, and we speak about energy. Yeah. And if I say in German, in the languages like this, when I say like teachers, there is a difference between a female and a male teacher, and there are many women like this, feminist women, activists from the left wing, who pretend that it should be like, female form in the language should be always separate, which is for me very ridiculous, to be honest. I wrote two books, and I had to correct the one of them under this aspect, because some people fall offended. So this is the one thing, and the other thing is that we have too many, turning back to entrepreneurship, we have too many female networks, too many, but they are too small. We have one big, this is the Verband Deutsche Unternehmerinnen, which is again the German Business Association of Women. Thanks to them we are here. This is the main one, the famous one, the most expensive one, which is also a problem for young entrepreneurs like me. I just can't afford to pay this fee every year. So the smaller ones are focused on, there are many women who are doing like yoga and massage and this and that, so a little bit esoteric for me, not too business-like, and there is not one central main one. It's missing from my point of view. So this discussion about gender is, I think Germany should support entrepreneurs in general, not only female entrepreneurs, because this is discussion about female or male is in the society since decades, I think.
So if there was, let's say, one business association, right, or one network, you think that the women would find space in that business association in general?
I forgot to tell you something. I have my own format, it's called Entrepreneurship Breakfast. And it was, first it was only for women, and then I realized that it's too limited, and that I discriminate men. So now I have two men with 15 women, two men, and the discussion is for me much better, to be honest. I think the men should be present, they shouldn't be the majority, but they should be at least 20% or 30% in a female organization.
Well, I mean, I counted the number of men in this room. There's five of us. How many men in this room? Please raise your hand. One, two, three, four, five, and
they should stay
10,
the majority,
six.
But
So this message goes to Sonia.
You are much more developed than Germany in this matter, I have to admit.
I mean, but I think you've raised an important point, right? Which